Good afternoon, everybody. Today we are working on the car again. It is a beautiful day out. Car update for where we are at currently. Obviously bumper, lights, everything's taken off of the front. The crash bar has been taken off. It is out being painted right now. I will show you guys that in a little bit. These have been all wiped down and degreased. We have paint match cans, so I'm gonna scrub this stuff, etc., make it look good. But this is all cleaned up. Inside the wheel well, we have repainted our fender liners so they're nice and black again. This isn't bolted on yet, but our big brake kit is being prepped to be put on. Pretty much this is all cleaned up, degreased. I'm gonna be painting these arms and then obviously swapping out the brake calipers back here. We pretty much just mocked this up so that we could check if dust shield is gonna fit. And it seems like it will with just minor hammering. It's not gonna scrape or rub or anything, so that's perfect. Pretty much gonna clean everything up and paint it. This goes for all four corners. Over here, same thing, same deal except with the drum. We pulled the drum off. We have new pads and drums coming in. When those get here, we're gonna install those. Did the same thing, painted all up here. And then we have new coils for the back. There's the bumper that we pulled off of the back. Off camera, I actually replaced these gas shocks. That is great. No more vice grip holding this up like it was in previous videos. Obviously, all the interior pieces are still in here. These are gonna come out when the car is ready to go to the body shop, but this interior window trim needs to come off on this side as well. And I have to dive into this side. We've only worked on that side of the car for now. And then out here, you can see the paint on our crash bar. Just for peace of mind, we sanded everything down, got majority of the surface rust off, then we just rattle canned it with some enamel. This is the battery tray I still need to do another coat on. Right now, I'm just gonna go ahead and grab my bucket, grab a brush, and start degreasing down all these arms and get them all cleaned up and ready for paint. I set up this little like paint booth area so I don't get any overspray anywhere. Masked off some, oh, there goes my light. Masked off some of this, and then now I'm just gonna go in with some matte black spray paint, and I cleaned up all the arms and stuff, so I'm just gonna give them a light coat. Now with the arms all painted up, we can now start to install our Wilwood Big Brake Kit. It's a two-piece rotor and a four-piston big brake. My two-piece rotor is already installed. It's just 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 bolts that combine this hub part to the rotor itself. This guy is gonna slide on here. And then we have our bracket adapter. So this guy is gonna go on something like so. And then you have your hardware that comes with the kit. So the ones that go to the adapter is the ones with the shims on it. Those ones right there. So I'm gonna go ahead and throw these on, and then we can start to mock up how the brakes are gonna bolt on. And then we swap out the stock lines for steel braided lines, and those go into the caliper, which will then go onto the rotor. All right, pretty straightforward. Got the adapter bracket put on here. Nice and solid. Obviously, two other sets of bolts for the other side. Now we have our steel braided brake line. Just gonna go in here next and undo this brake line. Replace this rubber hose with our new steel braided brake line, disconnect it from the shock, and then pull our old caliper off. Alrighty, we got our new brake line in. Our steel brake line is in now. Still need to pull this out and disconnect that. I will do that in a bit. I have old fluid draining because we are upgrading the fluid with these new brakes. I'm gonna remove the old caliper. And then I am getting the hardware ready for our new caliper to go in, and it fits in something like so, like that. A bolt comes in from the back and then a washer in between. Take a look at that. Take a look at these. That looks real good. I'm messing around with the amount of shims that you put in here to kind of adjust the back spacing of the caliper. Pretty much the way you want to adjust it is as if the rotor was pushed all the way back. You can see here, you can kind of see here, the spacing between this pad and this pad to the rotor. I slotted in the pads, and if you were to push against this and rotate the rotor how it would if the wheel was on, you could see it rubs up against that left pad, but not the right pad. So essentially what I'm gonna do is take some more shims and put them in between the bracket and the caliper. That way it pushes the caliper backwards and centers itself around this rotor. So that's essentially what I'm gonna do. I'm gonna slide more shims in there so it centers over the rotor, and that way there's no rubbing while this is spinning. Alrighty, after a lot of trial and error, I ended up going with 3 shims on this side. You could see them gold, the gold stuff in there. I ended up going with 3 shims there, so now when this guy rotates, this is tight and this rotates, it doesn't hit the pads anymore. I'm gonna go ahead and throw some anti-seize on these bolts so that if we need to maintenance them later, they will have no trouble getting them out. And then I'm gonna go ahead and throw the lug nuts on here to tighten this down to make sure it rotates straight. And I'm gonna do another test to make sure they don't rub. And then we should be good for this side there. I just need to grab brake fluid, throw on the line. And then obviously when I do all the other brakes, I'm gonna have to bleed it. For now, it looks like the driver's side is pretty much done. All right, we are all bolted up and torqued down. Another benefit to going big brakes besides just having great stopping power, from a practicality standpoint actually, instead of having to remove the whole brake caliper to change your pads, they actually just come with a cotter pin. You can actually just slide in your pads from the top, which makes it super, super easy for maintenance. So they just go in like that. You take your cotter pin. I'm not gonna lock it down or anything. But as you can see, with all those shims in, we can rotate the brake disc and no rubbing whatsoever. You can't hear anything. You could visually see it's all smooth. All I gotta do now is just add new brake fluid and toss in the line. And then this side is all done until we get our new suspension. It looks great. I can't wait for the new coils to be in and then our new wheels. That's gonna look amazing. Just when I thought I was all done, I actually took a look at the rotor and noticed it's kind of weird. Our slots are going this way. Well, if you actually look up here, there's an arrow, meaning rotational direction. Obviously that's pointing this way and the wheels move that way. It's the wrong side. I'm actually gonna pull this off. This goes on the passenger side, but luckily it shouldn't be too bad. Like shimming and adjustment is all done. All I gotta do is just unbolt 2 bolts at the top and bottom, slide this off and then put the new one on and then rebolt it again. I got the caliper off of here, but these bolts, see, that's a screw. That is supposed to be a Phillips bit. That's square, and so is this one. So, you know, 30-year-old bolts, they strip. I put some extra PB on them. Hopefully I could get them out later, but we'll get back to that all at this. So while I'm waiting for my dad to come back and help me get those seized bolts out, I went ahead and laid some coats on this fender liner so it looks nice and clean now. And I got the arm here painted up too. And then pretty much here we're just waiting on the new drums and pads. Until then, the back end of the car, or the rear end of the car and the wheel wells and stuff, is pretty much done until those parts come in. Obviously you guys saw that I got the brakes in. Next up, I'm gonna go ahead and work on getting that rear window trim off. And then I'm also going to come over here and I will paint this fuel rail eventually, but until I get a chance to mask everything off, because I need to paint this area too, I'm actually just gonna go in here with carb parts cleaner, clean out this throttle body because it's kind of gummed up. So I'm gonna clean this up, and then if I get a chance to, I'm gonna try to install that new clutch cable because the clutch slips because it's like a warped cable or something. By the way, little tool tip, I'm recording this after on my phone because my camera died. You heard me talking about I stripped the bolts to the OEM rotors. We were actually able to get them out with one of these square bits. Let's see if you can see that. I believe this is for like woodworking, and like it's like a contractor's bit, I believe they call it. I will actually link what it's actually called. Just threw that onto an impact driver. I'll show you what the bolts ended up looking like. This is what they ended up looking like. You can see how square they are. This one's not as bad, but so this was in here. Just took the little square bit and took the square bit and lined it up in here, then just pounded it in with a hammer.
and the impact was able to pry it out. So if you do like, if you build like canopies and stuff, I think we have this from our canopy, or any like woodworking, you probably have one of these laying around. This is a cheap, easy way to extract some bolts.
I finished up and I cleaned up that throttle body, and then I went ahead and sprayed the inside of the other wheel well. Probably the next video you'll see, we'll probably be doing a few more cleanup parts, and then we're gonna take it off to paint. Almost there, we're gonna try to make this deadline. The car looks good so far. I'm having fun working on it. Expect a lot more content to come. Some pretty consistent videos coming here soon. We got Mark and Mickey still working on editing, still working on everything. Just doing a little bit of filming on my end so that we can release content for you before or until they come back. But in the meantime, hope you enjoyed the video. TZ on me, TZ on 3, 1, 2, 3. Teasy.